Hey everyone, I was recently browsing Facebook and I noticed adverts for the all-new Eero Max 7, which is Eero's first Wi-Fi 7 compatible device. It joins a small number of mesh Wi-Fi competitors, including the TP-Link Deco BE85 and the Netgear Orbi 970. This is great, right? Wi-Fi 7 is here, and all of our devices will now suddenly be twice as fast, right? Well, nada. Most of my devices are still stuck on 5 GHz or even 2.4 GHz only. Even Amazon, who own Eero, keep mass producing millions of Ring and Echo devices that have no Wi-Fi 6 or 7 support whatsoever. And pretty much no one's phones or TV support Wi-Fi 7 either. So what gives? Is the Eero Max 7 a massive waste of money? Yes it is. Thanks for watching this video. If you liked it, please... Just kidding, sort of. In general, right now, buying the Eero Max 7 or similar Wi-Fi 7 model is a waste of money for most people. But there are some benefits to the Max 7, so let's explore those. Firstly, the Eero Max 7 has a max speed of almost 10 gigabits per second when wired, or 4.3 gigahertz per second in wireless mode. That's pretty awesome. While Wi-Fi 6 does, in theory, support these speeds, in reality, most previous gen Eero devices struggle to even hit gigabit speeds. The Max 7 also supports multi-gigabit backhaul, meaning that when you plug them all in, you won't then be limited to sub-gigabit speeds in other areas of your home. This is achieved by the Max 7 offering four Ethernet ports. Two are 10 gigs, and the other two are 2.5 gig. That's quite a nice benefit, actually, because so many routers and mesh Wi-Fi devices out there are still stuck offering gigabit ports only. Of course, there is a big downside here, ISPs. Many internet providers are still only offering sub-gigabit speeds, and that's certainly true here in the UK, and it's generally true in large parts of America too. So if an external internet connection is capped to a gigabit or less, you don't really need the Max 7, in my opinion. But would there be any benefit to buying the Max 7 in this case? Well, yes, actually. The Max 7 isn't just a minor upgrade, it features powerful Qualcomm networking hardware, and it also has a larger antenna array. This all means that the Eero Max 7 actually supports a wider range within the 5 and 6 GHz spectrums. This, it might not sound like much, but in practice, Wi-Fi signals on the Max 7 should actually have improved wall penetration, delivering a longer and more stable Wi-Fi signal to your wireless devices. Indeed, the range of the Max 7 is over 230 square meters per unit, which is pretty impressive. The improved hardware inside the Max 7 should also deliver lower latency, noticeably so in some cases, which is important for, you know, video conferencing along with gaming, of course. Quite a few early reviews have found this to be the case for them, which is reassuring. Although one guy keeps making the same comment in various Facebook threads and on Amazon reviews, which is a little bit suspect. But moving on from that, there are four reasons why I'm not personally upgrading my Eero Pro 6 setup just yet. Firstly, the Wi-Fi 7 standard is still very new and it hasn't even been fully ratified yet. I mean, the spec is unlikely to change in a way that makes the Max 7 redundant, of course, but it still feels a little too early for me right now. Secondly, there are some early adopter niggles. The Max 7 firmware is a bit more buggy than the Eero 6 and 6E firmware, with various compatibility issues reported. Plus, Eero ships this really expensive device with a 45-watt power supply. Apparently, this isn't always powerful enough, so users have then had to purchase their own 65-watt USB power supply to see increased performance, which they shouldn't really have to do. Thirdly, the price. Gosh, I mean, I get it. The Max 7 is Eero basically saying, look, we're a cutting-edge tech company, but £600 or $600 per unit is a lot. If you want Wi-Fi outside, you'll probably need to buy more than one unit, and immediately you're then paying over £1,000 or dollars. Yikes. If Wi-Fi 7 devices were widespread and I had a 10 gig internet connection, then I might buy the Max 7 when it's on sale. But I personally have no need to buy it right now. I am looking forward to Wi-Fi 7 though, and multi-link operation sounds really promising. This is a bit like HTTP2's stream multiplexing, which really improved website speeds all around the internet. Actually, technically it's a bit different because stream multiplexing basically involved a single TCP port per website, whereas MLO actually establishes multiple Wi-Fi band connections per device, then allows for mixing and matching for the best traffic delivery. But the end result is the same for both. Introducing a multi-lane highway will always result in faster and more reliable real-world performance. And that just about wraps up today's video. If I was suddenly rich and looking to buy a mesh Wi-Fi system, then the Max 7 would make sense. But I don't personally understand people saying, you know, I had an Eero 6E system and it was slow, but the Max 7 is resulting in much better speeds for me. I mean, like, really? You had an expensive system already and it wasn't working too well, so why upgrade with the same company? It's, you know, it's more likely that you've just had a problem with your networking setup, in my opinion. Anywho, if you have the money, then maybe buying the Max 7 makes sense, especially if you use Wi-Fi 6 a lot and you already own a couple of Wi-Fi 7 compatible devices. You're then investing in your home's networking future. But in all other cases, just buy a cheap Eero 6 system and relax, you'll be fine for 5 or even 10 years. Disagree with me though? Please let me know down in the comments. And I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please click the thumbs up button. Please also subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Thank you.